I'm headed up to the Two Rivers area on Lake Roosevelt. I'm going to be fishing with Rick Rovenio, who is the nephew of Gordon Steinmetz. Now, you may be familiar with that name. Gordon Steinmetz and his wife Marge owned and operated Big Wally's on the shores of Banks Lake for many years. Gordon also was a tournament walleye fisherman and had a guide service. I was very happy to learn that although they've sold Big Wally's and Gordon has retired from the guide service, he's passed it on to his nephew Rick, and that's who I'm going to meet. We're going to be headed up to Gordon's houseboat right there at the Two Rivers Marina and head out the next morning in search of walleye. We'll probably be fishing in the vicinity of Two Rivers, south of the lake on Lake Roosevelt proper, and then into the Spokane Arm, as the Two Rivers Marina sits right in the mouth of the Spokane River. So it looks like the weather's going to be in our favor, and I have never spent enough time on Lake Roosevelt, which is a wonderland for boating, other recreation, and also great fishing for walleye, smallmouth bass, big kokanee, and rainbow trout. So I can't wait to get up there and meet Rick, and his son Hayden is going to be fishing with us as well, and do some walleye fishing on Lake Roosevelt.
Here we are. Here's our buddies taking off next to us. Breaking a little ice this morning to get out of the marina. It's not bad. It was a little thicker yesterday, but much better today. All right, Rick, we're on the water.
All right, Dave. Well, we're up here on Lake Roosevelt, and we're just going to head out of the marina here, and we're not going to go very far. We've got a ridge out here that we were catching some nice fish on yesterday, and hopefully they're still there. A little winter walleye fishing on Lake Roosevelt. Broke some ice coming out of the marina, so being a little crazy today. But the sun's out and warming us up, and we're gonna give her a shot here.
And you found fish yesterday, both right out here outside the marina and then up the Spokane River, is that right?
We did, right out here by the mouth. We're gonna be jigging today with glow jigs and just worm on the hook, no rubber. We will have some jigs out with skirts on them, but pretty much yesterday, just the glow jigs with just a worm on the hook. We spray a little scent on there and go from there.
Hot dog. Well, I can't wait. Well, we're in position. There's Rick's buddies in the background. They're following us around because Rick knows where the fish are. And now we're going to be jigging today. And let's see what you got in your hand there.
Well, Dave, these are those glow jigs.
Right.
And actually, I need my chamber, which actually is a luminous lights that we can get it glowing.
Okay. Now, your chamber, is that different than we used to pop it with a...
Yep. Well, this is kind of a birthday gift I got.
Oh.
And it's a little chamber. Close it up. Give it a little light.
Oh, that's right. And it just intensifies the... Okay. Pretty slick.
And then what I like doing is not putting on a whole worm.
Okay.
I go about an inch or two below the hook. You can see.
Got it, yeah.
And for some reason with this live bait, the walleye seem to hang on to it. Throw a little scent on there. And let her go. We're gonna be we're going to be basically dragging jigs today.
Oh, okay.
Try to go about 0.5 miles an hour. And there's two ways you can do this. You can, what we call dead sticking, just put it in the rod holder, and believe it or not, these fish will grab it and hang on to it.
Mm-hmm.
Yesterday it was working good, working these jigs a little bit.
Just a little bit.
Just a little bit.
With colder water temperatures, they're not going to go 2 or 3 feet to chase down a jig. It's got to be pretty easy pickings for them. Is that right?
That's right. And their bites, most of the time you don't feel a bite. What you're going to feel is just weight. And
just gets
heavy. If you've
done
enough jigging, you just know it's something different. You know it's a fish. You know, a lot of times you'll feel weight, and then maybe you'll feel a couple little tugs. But, you know,
yeah.
Just knowing how to jig fish and what a bite is, they're very lethargic this time of year.
Right. So it's a real touch technique.
We're going to be fishing. Yesterday we found the fish from about 43 to 48 feet out here at the mouth.
Okay.
So we're going to try to keep her in that strike zone and catch some fish.
Let's go to work.
Got him. No, he's right on the top of the mouth.
All right, Dave, you got one?
My God. You know what? Just like you said, I just felt heavy. You know, there wasn't any real bouncing of the rod or anything. And so, you know, hook sets are free, Rick, so I just let him have it. And it's not exactly a bragger, but we got fish in the boat.
Yeah, about a 12-incher, a good eater.
Oh, yeah, that's a nice fish. Very nice.
No one is happy about having to repair a vehicle after an accident. However, I was very happy when I chose First Choice Collision Center when I needed this service. I can't say enough about how they treated me. Fast and friendly just doesn't say enough. They have amazing technology to make a damaged vehicle look like new. At First Choice Collision Center, you can expect modern service with old-fashioned values. That was my experience, and I'm sure it will be yours too.
Your Town Ford is kicking off the season with the best deals of the year. It's the Built Ford Tough Truck Event. Great power and amazing fuel economy means no compromises. And that's what you get in a truck built Ford Tough. Like the Ford F-150 with a powerful and efficient EcoBoost engine. The power you want and the economy you need. Or Ford Super Duty with its amazing 6.7-liter power stroke turbo diesel. If you're looking for power, payload, towing economy, Your Town Ford's got the truck for you. Head to Your Town Ford in East Wenatchee.
Hayden hooks up. This looks like the real deal, too.
He ain't that big. He didn't like it when I set the hook, though.
He did. He put a nice bend in that rod. That was okay. And you're in 52 feet up there?
Was.
Okay, well, let's see what we got here.
Yep.
There he is. All right.
Another good eater.
Not bad.
And the hook comes right out.
Nice. Okay, all of a sudden, man, I better get my bait back down there. We got a little bite going. And now Rick reared back. Holy moly.
He thinks he's big.
We got a nice little bite going here all of a sudden. And this one was on a blade bait. We get this fish in here, and we'll show you what that means. It's a little bit different technique.
And it's a technique that, other than these jigs, oh, this is a decent fish. Might want to net this one. There's a little better fish.
Now we're talking.
Oh, that's a good fish there.
Nice, Rick. Way to go. Now, that last fish came on board when you were casting a blade bait. What's that baby look like
well,
here?
It's just basically a piece of metal. It's a jig, and it's weighted up front. They come in a variety of colors. What you do is you can vertical jig it straight up and down, or you can cast it and let it hit the bottom and jig it back. And it's just quick jigs. It's another very popular winter winter bait for walleye. It comes in a bunch of different colors. I like silver. I put some red eyes on this. If you looked in my box here, definitely tell I like silver, but you can see it comes in a variety of colors. I've made up some blues there. And
you add your own little touches to it.
Yeah, little tiger stripes on some.
Yeah. And those kind of get a buzz. They flutter.
They flutter. They act like a wounded fish. When you lift them up, they flutter up.
Uh-huh.
And then you drop it down slack and they flutter down. And usually on these, you won't feel a bite. When you start to lift up, they've already picked it up and you'll feel a little weight, set the hook, and it's a fish.
Well, that first stop wasn't bad, Rick. That was good for three fish in the boat, and we missed a couple more. But not fast enough for you guys.
Not fast enough, so we're going to head up river and try another spot where yesterday we couldn't even get two rods down before we had fish on. So we're going to head up river and give that a shot.
Sounds like a great spot, and this is above the bridge over the Spokane River.
That's correct.
And so we're going to run right past the marina up below the bridge and try the place that was the hot spot yesterday anyway.
Let's give it a shot.
Yep, we're going to move our operation up into the Spokane River. This is a great marina here. I know my buddy Gordon loves having his houseboat here. It's hard to get him off of it in the season. There's our bridge over the Spokane River. This is a very popular area with walleye fishermen in the spring. Looks like Rick's buddy's got a fish on up there. All right.
That's so small, it looks like a walleye.
Looks like a walleye, only smaller. A
perch. All right, now we're getting some bites. All of a sudden, things are picking up. They got a fish on ahead of us. Rick just hooked up, and then Hayden just missed one. We just about had a double. Oh, there's a nice fish, too.
Good eater there, Dave.
Gosh, yeah. That's okay. Here we go. Now we're getting into them. I'm liking this.
Perfect little eaters there.
Hot dog. Exactly, you know, and that's what you're looking forward to is a really nice walleye feed after today. Woohoo! Okay, now we're tucked up above the bridge, maybe a half mile or something, fishing around an island up here, but this is probably just one of many spots that you fish on the Spokane River. Is that right, Rick?
It is. It's always my first stop because we're, of course, start at the bottom and work our way up. There's lots of flats. You probably can't see up the river now, but there's lots of flats that the fish hang on all the way up to Porcupine Bay, and then the river narrows down, and then it can get a little sketchy up in there. But pretty much as far as Porcupine Bay, you look for the flats and the points, and you can see them going around corners. There's usually parks on boat in parks on the flats, so they're easy to find, and you just find a depth that the fish are at and, you know, target them there. You know, we're again today working, you know, anywhere from 30 to 50 feet. We're kind of finding fish scattered in all those depths, but that's what it takes up the Spokane Arm, just finding the fish and fishing those flats and switching your depths till you find it, and there you go.
I noticed Porcupine Bay Campground. I passed that on my way driving down here to Two Rivers. Is that, and there's a boat launch and good facilities there too?
Boat launch and a campground, and that's a good destination this time of year because mm-hmm. these fish are staging the spawn, and you know, of course they spawn throughout the lake, but you know, a lot of fish travel up these rivers to spawn up these rivers, so that's what the anglers are targeting.
Spokane Arm's a good place in the early spring. And then
During the later spring and summer months, the fish, after they spawn, they move out into the main lake, and that's where you concentrate
that's
more?
That's where you concentrate, but there's still fish in here.
Sure.
I mean, you can come up here and catch fish, you know, but a lot of fish disperse back into the main lake, and then you target them out there.
As winter settles into our area, many savvy anglers are shifting their attention to the big reservoirs. Lake Roosevelt, Rufus Woods, and Banks Lake all offer great trout fishing in the winter, and Hooked on Toys has what you need to get them. Ask Rick what he uses to catch the big triploids at Rufus Woods, and you'll find what you need for fishing from shore or from a boat on the shelves at Hooked on Toys. See them at 1444 North Wenatchee Avenue, or visit them online at hookedontoys.com.
Hi, I'm Dave Graybill, the Fishing Magician, and I'm sitting in front of the Lake Pateras Inn. Lake Pateras Inn is one of the most convenient places you can stay if you like to fish for salmon or steelhead on the Upper Columbia River. You can moor your boat at the dock, or there are two ramps within yards. They have outdoor power so you can charge your electric motor. Rooms are clean and comfortable and very affordable. Everything you need is right here at the Lake Pateras Inn.
All right. See, these guys just slid in over to our spot, and all of a sudden now they're catching fish. All right, good job. All right.
I was hung up on that log and I reeled it about halfway up, and this one got hung up, so I let go of it, and this one was, as soon as I picked it up.
All right, that's a good fish.
That was not bad.
All right. You guys are filling the box now. There's another one.
On
our better buddy's boat, another jig and worm set up. Woo! There he is.
Whoa.
All right, another fish in the boat. This isn't bad. This is a nice spot up here in the Spokane arm.
You see, Dave, we're kind of just hanging on one spot because walleye are a school in fish.
I got a hold of that one.
So we're trying to target the school.
Hayden, in the holder, that's the way to catch them.
Yeah. Don't pay attention to your rod, that's how we do it.
A lot of times I'm better off that way. Oh, good. It's another eater.
Stinger.
Yep, got him on the stinger hook. Great.
So Hayden just brought a kid home, didn't he?
All right, another one for the box. Good job.
All right, now we got Dave in the action.
All right, feels good, boy. My rod was quiet there for a while.
He was just complaining that he hadn't had a fish in a while.
There we go.
There we go, nice walleye.
Glow hook.
Another good eater.
Not bad.
Awesome.
Woohoo!
All right, what you got there, Dave?
I think you would call that a juvenile.
Hold it closer to the camera, it makes it look bigger.
Yeah.
Trick photography.
Well, like you say, that's a good eater. While I've got this fish, Rick, what is the length and limit for Lake Roosevelt walleye?
There's no limit, or no size limit.
Uh-huh.
So you can keep a 4-incher
right.
And 8-fish limit.
Eight fish limit. Well, that makes for a nice fillet right there. All right, fun
nice
stuff.
Fish. We got a good fish there, Dave?
Oh, it's just about a little better.
It's a little better fish. Oh, yeah.
Not bad.
Stopped and had a little bite to eat, and that's the best time to catch fish when you're busy.
This one looks like it's got a leader coming out.
Somebody up.
Yeah, it's moss jaws. All right.
Nice fish.
So this one isn't a monster.
Yeah, this one isn't very big.
Used my trick though, took a bite of that sandwich. Well, what do you know actually? Hey.
Not too bad.
That's not too bad at all, Rick.
Just didn't have the fight in him.
Yeah. Hot dog.
Another fish on a glow jig?
Yes, that's working great today. Yep, I tell you what, that live well's getting crowded.
It's getting full.
This is the third fish in short order.
We should have been eating all day.
Yeah, we should always have a sandwich in our hand. Oh, that's a
little better fish.
I like that.
I want to net that one.
Nice. Look at that. And the hook just came right out.
Not a 17 incher.
Yes. Way to go, Rick. Yeah, we thought we missed that one, but you got him. All right.
Good fish.
He pounded it.
We keep talking about leaving and we keep hooking fish. Yeah. He's got a decent fish there. Well, he's a little guy, but hey, I tell you what.
He's mad.
He keeps the... Yeah, look at that guy.
He ain't very happy. He's all flared out.
They just keep coming. This is great.
Every time we threaten to leave, let's do that more often.
All right, Dave, you got another one there?
Yeah, by golly. That glow hook. That's about the size of Hayden's fish.
Yep, and we just got bit off on the other rod.
We've got another nice flurry going.
Yep, another little bite going.
All right.
All right, good job, Dave.
Looks like our buddies have got another fish on.
You're milking it like it's a toad.
All right.
The goal of battery systems is to provide the best products combined with the most efficient service at competitive prices. I've found their people live up to this, so don't buy anything without talking to them. You should make their batteries and accessories your choice to power your vehicles and boats. This is Dave Grable, and I choose battery systems to keep me running on shore and on the water. To find a battery systems product expert in a location near you, log on to batterysystems.net.
Gaboon Productions LLC is a full-service video production company right here in the Wenatchee Valley. Gaboon is a term coined by my grandfather, commercial fishing in Alaska. It's when a bunch of fish hit your net all at the same time. We capture life as you see it. From filming those special moments to catching something big, Gaboon Productions LLC can record it, edit it, and save it for you forever. We do weddings, theater productions, concerts, reunions, commercials, and more. Go to GaboonProductions.com on the web, check us out on Facebook and on YouTube. Gaboon Productions LLC, the little video company capturing your big moments.
Okay, we're back at the dock. And here is Rick giving us a demonstration. Now, he's a man of my heart. Notice he's using an electric knife. And I'll tell you what, this can make the work go a lot quicker.
Gotta have the electric.
And let me zoom in here and you can watch how he does it. Yeah, he just leaves that still attached and zips it off.
And we cut out the ribs and the belly there. And a nice little fillet.
Just that quick and easy. Not bad.
This is awesome for doing a lot of fish.
I want to find one with about a 12-inch blade so I can do my kings. The big kings.
Well, this will work for them.
Yep.
And you can do kings. Same way.
Exactly the same way. Makes a real pretty fillet. Nice job.
Well, we're off the water back at Two Rivers Marina. Rick Rovenio and I have had a great day with his son Hayden in our boat out there chasing walleye in the very early spring. We were breaking ice in the marina getting out to the main lake this morning.
Crazy winter walleye fisherman.
Absolutely. And it was worth it.
It was. It was a good day out there.
We really only fished three spots and we were really within sight of the marina the whole time.
and caught fish everywhere we went today. Now, that first flat that we fished just down below the marina was pretty productive. Now, one of the things that when I mentioned I was headed up here to fish at Lake Roosevelt was they fish deep up there.
They do. Some guys go as deep as 100 feet.
Oh, my
goodness.
To catch
these walleye up here, and it's one of the few places where you really can find them from 100 feet down to 5 feet.
And I think the last spot we were fishing, we were pulling fish from a little over 50 feet.
Yep, 53 feet, 54 feet.
Right. Well, one of the things that I enjoyed about today, and I think if you're just getting into walleye fishing, you'll enjoy too, because the techniques were fairly straightforward, and the tackle wasn't very complicated either. And one of the favorites I think we found today was that good, what you called the glowhead jig.
Yeah, it's a luminous jig that with a shot of LED lights glows down at the depths we're fishing, and it's the ticket, and it's simple.
It's very simple. Why don't you show, you've got a rod now too with one of those on it right here, I think it is. And this is a one-piece rod, which was really nice. You know, it's a great feeling rod. It's got a nice balance to it. And this glow head, is this a half ounce?
It's a 3/8.
3/8 ounce glow head. And also, Rick had the neatest little contraption here today. It's made by Rapala, and it's a light box. You called it a compartment?
I call it the coffin.
But
it's just like a glasses case that has 8 LED lights in it. You stick your jig, or you can stick a glow plug or anything in it.
Yeah, because it was about 8 inches long. So yeah, you could get a whole plug in there. Close her down and hit it for
10 seconds and you're good to go.
That was great. And that just pops, makes these things so bright. And of course, as like I said earlier, we were taking fish in depths of 50 feet today, and it's dark down there. And so this is going to get the fish's attention. And then you'll notice this too. This is the first time I've ever fished a jig head without any kind of skirt or anything. You just slid a night crawler up there and all the way up until, you know, most of these jigs will have a little sort of
a barb
on them, exactly. And that'll hold that night crawler in place. And then just send her on down after you've put on a little bit of secret sauce.
A little bit of secret scent on it. One key is in this time of year, you know, a lot of times these walleye aren't wanting big baits, and they're light biters. So when we put the worm on there, we're only leaving about a half an inch below the hook.
I'm glad you mentioned that too. You're not putting a whole night crawler on this thing at all. You're pinching it off, like you say, so it's only extending below the bend in the hook about a half an inch or so.
Because you've seen it today, we had a couple missed bites where your worm's bit off right at your hook. They're just picking up the bottom end. If you got a 6-inch night crawler on there, you're not going to hook very many fish.
Absolutely. That's a really good point to make. Rick, if someone wanted to get a hold of you, talk to you about walleye fishing, and maybe even book a trip up here, what's the best way to do that?
Well, we have Big Wally's Guide Service on the web. You can get a hold of me through my email, which is Dick and Tam, D-I-K, N as in Nancy, T-A-M, @comcast.net, or my phone number, which is area code 206-954-4570.
That's great. And I tell you what, my experience today is just representative of what you could expect with a trip with Rick. It was just a great time, and he's got everything you need for a great day on the water and learn about the thrill of hooking some walleye. And of course, as I said before, not only the fun of fishing for walleye, which is always a great time, especially in this beautiful area too, but also the end result, which is walleye in the pan.
Walleye in the pan.
If you have not had the chance to taste fresh walleye, it's worth booking a trip just for that, because once you've tasted fresh walleye, you're doomed. You're going to be a walleye fisherman from then on.
Well, Rick, thank you so much.
Thank you, Dave.
It's about time we got to manage to get our schedules together and make this happen.
I had a great time today.
I really appreciate it, and I look forward to doing it again sometime.
It sounds good.